John, could you please tell us what the situation is with you and your entering the United States?
A lot of people don't want me in, you know. They think I'm going to cause a violent revolution, which I'm not. Mm-hmm. And the others don't want me in because they don't want me to cause peace either, you know. Because peace is big, war is big business, you know, and they like war because it keeps them fat and happy. And I'm anti-war, so they're trying to keep me out, but I'll get in. You know, because they'll have to own up in public that they're against peace, you know.
Mm-hmm. What can we, as the youth of Toronto, like, what can we do to try and help you?
Help me by helping yourselves, you know, and the militant revolutionaries, ask them to show you one revolution that turned out to be what it promised militantly. That's take Russia, France, anywhere they're at it. What they do is they smash the place down, then they build it up again, and the people that build it up hang on to it. And then they become the establishment. Now you guys are going to be the establishment in a few years. It's not worth knocking it down, because it's convenient to have the rooms and the machinery. The thing is to protest, but protest non-violently. Because violence begets violence, you know, and if you run around wild, you get smacked, and that's it, you know, that's the laws of the universe. And they've got all the weapons, they've got all the money, and they know how to fight violence because they've been doing it for thousands of years, suppressing us. Mm-hmm. And the only thing they don't know about is non-violence and humour. And there's many ways of promoting peace. Do everything for peace. Kiss for peace, or smile for peace, or go to school for peace, or don't go to school for peace. Whatever you do, just do it for peace. You know? It's up to the people. You can't blame it on the government and say they're doing this, they're going to put us into war. If we put them there, and we allow it, you know, and we can change it. If we really want to change it, we can change it.
What about the Paul, Ringo, what's his name?
George.
We're all four individuals, and George is saying to me, George is doing it in his own way, with the way he goes about his life. It's no good shouting on the street corner, I want peace, and then beating up your mates, you know. You've got to try and work your own head out, you know, and get non-violent. And it's pretty hard, because we're all violent inside. We're all Hitler inside, and we're all Christ inside. And it's just to try and work on the good bit of you.
How can I go forward when I don't know which way I'm facing? How can I go forward when I don't know which way to turn? How can I give love when I just don't?